Hello everyone. Today in this class, I am going to explain network elements. To understand these network elements, I am considering a small family consisting of father, mother, and three children. Okay? So, children number one, children number two, the children number three. So there are three children and father, mother. Total five characters in this small family. Okay. So let us come to the characteristics of these five people. Generally, in a family, father is going to end the money. And whatever he earns the money, he is going to give to the mother. So in some families, both father and mother are going to earn the money. So I am just taking a small family here. In this case, mother is a housewife. She is going to distribute the money as a pocket money to all the three children in an equal manner. So she is going to distribute some amount of money to their three children, and whatever the remaining amount, she is going to give it to father again. So the remaining amount of money is going to give to the father. Okay. So these pocket money which they got from the mother, he is going to spend this. Kid number one, the children, is going to spend that money in various forms without storing single amount of rupees. Okay. And these two children, children number two and children number three, they are going to save that pocket money. They are going to save the pocket money. And whenever this children one required that amount of money, even though he is spending in various forms, they are going to donate that money. Okay? Cooperating each other. In a small family or in any family, among the three kids or among the kids, one of the kid is closely associated with father. And one of the kid is closely associated with the mother. Very close. Closely associated. Okay. Now, let us convert these five characters into our electrical terminology. Okay. In our electrical terminology, father is nothing but the voltage source. And mother is nothing but current flowing through the circuit. And this kid number one, I am just taking it as a resistor. And this kid number two, I am considering it as an inductor. And this kid number three, I am considering it as a capacitor. So this is our simple series RLC circuit consisting of voltage, current, resistor, inductor, capacitor. In this example, father is the voltage source, mother is the current flowing through the circuit. This is the source and this is the current flowing through the circuit. And this kid one is a resistor. Kid number two is an inductor. Kid number three is the capacitor. Okay. Now, resistor is always going to spend whatever the current which is flowing through that circuit in the form of I square R losses. We can call this as copper losses. Okay, and these two are the storage elements. I already told you these two elements will be saving the in this example they are going to save the money. So here money is nothing but current which is flowing through that elements, and these are the storage elements. Okay, so how they are going to store energy stored in the elements? In the inductor, it is going to store as half Li square. Capacitor, it is going to store as half CV square. So I already told you this in this family, one of the kid is closely associated with father. Father is nothing but voltage source. Who is that kid? Capacitor. So capacitor will be storing the energy in the form of half CV square. One of the kid is closely associated with mother. Mother is nothing but current here, and it is going to store in the form of half Li square. Here this kid number 2 is inductor. Okay, so this is a small example to understand the electrical network elements. These active elements are voltage and current. Passive elements are resistor, inductor and capacitor. Okay, so in this case, in this example, the voltage source is independent variable and the current is the dependent variable. Okay.